From the streets of Toronto in November to the treacherous ISIS battleground outside Kobani just a few weeks later, a young Canadian woman identified as L.A. and Toronto Jane is geo-tracked leaving Toronto for Syria, her journey to jihad traced by her mobile phone every time she posts on Twitter.
Why is a female there? And the only thing that we can come up with in terms of an explanation is she's doing spying activities for ISIS.
Jeff Wires is a researcher with IBRABO, an intelligence research group tracking those at risk of violent extremism. If indeed she's the one sending the tweets, he says the ground Toronto Jane has covered, the access she's had to the front lines, is unprecedented for a woman, even moving through ISIS enemy territory.
After arriving in Iraq, she starts traveling all over Syria. So again, this is something we've never seen in a female profile before.
She arrived first in Iraq, the so-called ISIS capital, moves to Aleppo, and then all the way to Mosul in Iraq, with stops in between. She then pops up on Twitter on another ISIS front line near Kobani. Her Twitter posts are in Arabic, most in praise of ISIS. Quote me, she writes, they treated me as a sister, and I have seen no kindness like theirs.
Even online, you're seeing women engaging with ISIS, engaging with the ideology of ISIS to an extent that we've never seen before.
What is the attraction? What do you, from the social media posts that you see, what makes them gravitate towards ISIS?
From a social media perspective, there's never been a group like ISIS. There's never been a group that's engaged in the amount of propaganda, the amount of recruiting.
Researchers know her name but are not releasing it, and Toronto Jane is now under investigation by police here in Canada, where new and proposed laws mean she would likely be arrested the minute she tried to return.
So that's a really interesting case because the only evidence they would have is Twitter posts, that's speech. Now, in this case, she's gone to Syria, and I would suspect that they will have additional evidence about connection she has, who arranged her travel, who financed her travel, and what was the purpose of her travel, and which group is she supporting on the ground.
And they also want to learn about her Toronto connections.
What information is she passing along to ISIS now that she's over there and can relay that information? And did she have any supporters while she was here in Toronto? That would be the greater question to try and figure out.
Definitely a possibility that she could have been a threat.
Oh, definitely.
In one of her last posts from Kobani in recent days, she defends the savage burning of the Jordanian pilot by ISIS. If you were looking for evidence, she writes, torturing by fire was exempted by the Prophet, and we exempt what he exempted. Canadian researchers say they have no idea if Toronto Jane knows she's being followed, but the Twitter account has now been deactivated. Paula Newton, CNN, Toronto.